أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لتراب مقدمه الفداء. My very dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Congratulations on the auspicious occasion of the birth anniversary of Imam al-Hujjah ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif, our savior al-muntazir wal-muntazar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hasten his reappearance wa ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Jazakumullah khair al-jaza, especially to the youth and all the organizers of this great celebration. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Indeed, had it not been the grace and the blessing of the Almighty God, we would not have been able to make it, and we would not have been able to celebrate and pay such a great respect, inshallah, to our present Imam, ajjalallahu farajahu sharif. Alhamdulillah ala ni'matil Islam, alhamdulillah ala ni'matil Iman, wa kafa bihima ni'ma. Alhamdulillah for the blessings of Islam and Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among those who practice that blessed ayah of the Quran that says, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Make sure and endeavor that you live an Islamic life and you die not but as a Muslim, inshallah, and as a believer and believers in Ahlul Bayt, in Islam, and in all the true concept of Islam. I was very much, in fact, touched by the presentations of the choir group and the youth, especially the skit and the play that they were performing. To be honest with you, I had a goosebump during the play. And especially thank you very much, mashallah, to Ahmad Rashid. I don't know whether our friends, brothers and sisters, they know or not. I wish Haj Ali had announced that Ahmad Rashid, who just ended that play with a short poem in Farsi. For your information, he's not Iranian. He doesn't speak Farsi, he doesn't know Farsi. So if you want to imagine that how much efforts he's put really to memorize this poem in the love of Imam Mahdi ajjalallahu farajahu sharif and present it to all of us. Please pray for him and for all those who have made this night, inshallah, and this event happen. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alif lam mim. Dhalikal kitabu la rayba fih. Hudan lil muttaqin. Alladhina yu'minuna bil ghaib. Sadaq Allahu al-Aliyyu al-Azim. I'm afraid all of you know this part of the Quran that I just recited, the beginning of the second chapter of the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins with one of the mysterious huruf al-muqatta, the separated letters, and soon after that says that dhalika al-kitab, that book, perhaps referring most likely to the Holy Quran, la rayba fih, there is no doubt about it, and no one can cast and question the validity of it. Hudan lil muttaqin, it has guidance for the pious people, for God-fearing people, for those who ward themselves against evil. And then Quran introduces the muttaqin and says, alladhina yu'minuna bil ghaib. One of the first characteristics of muttaqin is that they believe in the unseen, ghaib, opposite of shahada. When we can see something physically, this is shahada, seen, visible. Things that are not visible and we cannot physically, in a normal way, see them, in the language of the Quran referred to as ghaib or unseen and invisible, whatever translation you want to suggest. Now, the topic that inshallah I have for you tonight, and hopefully I won't keep you lying, is to prove the living of Imam Mahdi Ajallallah Farajahu Sharif. If you are talking especially with some non-Muslims, or in particular because the issue of belief in Imam Mahdi is common among all Muslims, but the difficulty or the debate or the dialogue that we have with people of different branches of Islam is about whether Imam Mahdi is already born and is in occultation as we believe, or he's yet to be born. Absolute majority, perhaps all Sunni schools of thought, although they believe in Imam Mahdi Ajallallah Farajahu Sharif, but they believe that Mahdi is yet to be born. He is not born yet. So what we have, inshallah, in short tonight, to see how we can present it to our Sunni brothers and sisters, to prove it to them that no, this is not a right belief in Imam Mahdi. Imam Mahdi has been already born from Imam Hassan al-Askari alayhi salam as his father, and he is living, but he is in occultation. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, in interpretation of the ayah in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah that I just recited for you, the Imam says that muttaqeen are the true followers of Islam. Muttaqeen, to be more precise, are Shi'at Ali, Shi'at Imam Ali alayhi salam. I'm quoting the hadith from Kamaluddin of Sheikh Saduq rahmatullah alayhi. And then the Imam furthers that those who believe in ghaib, one of the examples of belief in ghaib and the unseen, is believing Imam Mahdi that they have not seen him physically yet. They don't have the opportunity easily, nor in a normal way, to go and visit the Imam. Whereas at the time of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, no one would doubt the existence of the Imam. They could easily, if easily or hard, however, they would make a trip to Medina and I would see Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. Whereas for us, the followers of Ahlul Bayt al-Muslim, at the time of occultation, our present Imam is not visible to us. So we have to have faith and believe in the existence of the Imam, whose existence is hidden from us. All right. Now, because it's a happy occasion, let me share with you some hadith, inshallah, to encourage you, on the condition that, inshallah, you don't feel too much proud of yourselves. As followers, as the believers of Ahlul Bayt, alayhi salam, although we have not seen our Imam, but inshallah, we have absolutely no doubt about his existence, these ahadith apply to us, the rewards that Ahlul Bayt, alayhi salam, have promised us. One hadith. The first hadith is something that Shaykh al-Mufid rahmatullah alayhi is narrating from the Holy Prophet of Islam, that the Prophet, one day he was sitting with his companions and he said, Ya laytani qad laqitu ikhwani, I wish I could meet with my brothers. Shaykh al-Mufid narrates that Abu Bakr and Umar, they turn and on said that, Ya Rasulallah, are we not your brothers? The Prophet said that, you are my companions. But remember, notice, I was longing to meet and see my brothers. They said, Ya Rasulallah, then who are your brothers? The Prophet said, my brothers are alladhina ya'tuna min ba'dikum yu'minuna bi wa yuhibbuni wa yansuruni wa yusaddiquni wa ma ra'awni. My brothers, that you can imagine that the relation of brotherhood is so close to someone. And that's why the Prophet of Islam exclusively made brotherhood with Imam Ali alayhi salam, at least in two occasions, and with nobody else. That brotherhood, the Prophet of Islam is extending us, let us see, to who? The Prophet says that my brothers are those that they will be born after me. They have not physically seen me. They believe in ghaib, as we do believe in ghaib, in the existence of the Prophet and the Imams. Isn't it? For us, all of them, none of them, we have seen them. All of them are in sort of unseen, as far as physically we are concerned. So the Prophet says that they are the ones who believe in me. They love me. They support my cause, and they have not ever seen me. That's why I'm so much eager in earnest to see them and meet with them, inshallah, at the Hawd of Kawthar, in the pool of Kawthar, on the Day of Judgment. This is one hadith. The second hadith is from Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, that Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, he is talking about the time of major occultation, our time as part of it. That Imam Sajjad alayhi salam says that, Inna ahla zaman ghaybateh والقائلين بإمامته والمنتظرين لظهوره أفضل من كل زمان. الله أكبر. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam says that Shia, the followers of Ahlul Bayt, at that time, at the time of ghibat, occultation of who? Our present Imam. That we have not been there when Imam was born. We don't have the blessing of normally seeing him as followers of Ahlul Bayt at the time of the previous Imams they did. Imam Sajjad says that people at that time, like our time, that they have not seen their Imam, yet they believe in him, they are the best and the most virtuous and the most pious people of all centuries. Because people at the time of the Prophet, they have seen the Prophet, they had seen the miracles of the Prophet, they had seen Imam Ali and the miracles of Imam Ali and so forth. And yet if they didn't believe in them, imagine how devil they would be. Whereas for us, we can say, Ya Rab, I have not seen Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif in a way that, for example, Shia at the time of Imam Kadhim, Imam Sajjad, other Imams would see them. But I have no doubt about his existence. And the wisdom in that, I think the analogy, the reason that Imam Sajjad says that they are the best people of all the time, all best Muslims, is obvious. And the Imam himself, he says, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them enough intellect, well, fahm, an understanding, that although they do not see their Imam, but it's for them like as if they have seen him. So sarat bihil ghaybatu anhum bimanzilatil mushahada. I'm quoting the hadith exactly. That Imam says that the occultation of the Imam to them is exactly as if the Imam is apparent. His occultation does not affect their faith and their belief in the existence and the living of the Imam, so much so that they really believe in that. يَرَوْنَهُ وَلَا يَعْرِفُونَ. That they know that he sees them and he knows them, even though we may see him and we do not recognize him. Mirza Jawad Maliki Tabrizi was one of the teachers of Imam Khomeini, rahmatullah alayhi, in Irfan. In fact, Mirza Jawad was more of the teacher of the Imam in practical Irfan. When they asked him that, Sheikhna, have you seen Imam Mahdi? Not in dream, in real. He says, no, I have not seen my Imam, but I'm happy that he sees me always. And my concern is that when he sees me, in which status I am, in which situation he sees me, when he sees me, does he see me while I'm committing a sin, by seeing, hearing, talking, my heart and the rest, or now I'm in the state of worshipping. Inshallah, Imam Mahdi Ajjalallahu Farajahu Sharif is seeing all of us while we are in the state of worshipping in the house of God, the house that is named after Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Do you want more gift or that's enough? Let's add into it from other Imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam. These are all as a bunch of flower, a gift from Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam on the auspicious occasion of the birth anniversary of Imam Mahdi ajjalallahu farajahu sharif to the lovers of Mahdi who got together tonight to celebrate his birth. Imam Kadhim alayhi salam. We had a hadith from the Prophet, from Imam Sajjad, now Imam Kadhim alayhi salam. Imam Kadhim alayhi salam says that those people, those of followers of Ahlul Bayt at the time of major occultation who believe in al-Mahdi without having seen him, wallahum wallahi ma'ana fi darajatina yawm al-qiyamah. Again, I'm quoting from the book of Sheikh al-Saduq called Kamaluddin, that Imam Kadhim alayhi salam takes an oath and he said, by Allah, they are with us on the day of judgment in our degrees. Inshallah, on the day of judgment, those who have no doubt whatsoever about the existence of Imam Mahdi, his occultation to them is of no difference of whether he was appear or not, then they are to the level of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam on the day of judgment. And that's why the Prophet says to Imam Ali alayhi salam that, Ya Ali, do you know the faith and the iman of what group of people is more amazing me? is those the face of those who without seeing us they believe in us. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. Those who believe in the unseen without having seen the Prophet Imam Ali Ahlul Bayt, yet they so crystal clear they believe in them. And the Prophet says that how did they believe? Said Ya Ali, they believe آمَنُوا بِسَوَادٍ عَلَى بَيَاضٍ. Ya Ali, they looked at some black and believed in white. Noor. What is black? Meaning that because they made some investigation and studied the books. From the books, from the historical evidences, they came to believe in us. Like the way that you and I believed in Ahlul Bayt, alayhi salam, in Islam, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Day of Judgment and everything. It is through education. And by black, the Prophet means because in the old days and still the common ink is black. Writing with writings that are in black, you believe in white, in nur of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. Despite this, from the time of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, and even before that, there were some misgivings about the existence of Imam, whether Imam Mahdi is going to exist in our time or not. The very first who clarified that one was Imam Sadiq alayhi salam himself, and he foretold that time will come that different Muslims will be in different categories and different beliefs with regards to Imam Mahdi. And even among Shia, so-called Shia though, those who claim to be the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, you see some, not all of them, have a strong belief and faith in Imam Mahdi ajallallahu farajahu sharif. Says that, but you know the wisdom behind that Mahdi goes to occultation, the wisdom for that, he says, the Imam says that because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuhibbu an yamtahina shi'a, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to test those who claim that they are the lovers of Ahlul Bayt, those who give a lip service to Islam, to distinguish them from those who truly and really they believe in Ahlul Bayt and in Islam. And the Imam says that فَعِنْدَ ذَلَكَ يَرْتَابُ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. The followers of falsehood, they are the only ones that they would be doubting the existence of Imam Mahdi Ajallallah Farajahu Sharif. Inshallah, in the remaining time, I share with you some of those sawad that the Prophet mentioned, some of those historical evidences that between Shia and Sunni, there is absolutely no question about the authenticity of these evidences through which we want to prove the existence of our present Imam, Imam al-Hujja Ajallallah Ta'ala Farajahu Sharif, with one loud salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad again. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الذِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so crystal clear in that time will come that the pious, righteous people of our servants, they are the ones who will be inheriting the earth, meaning that they are the ones who will establish a global, just and Islamic state. Alright. And the ayat that we have in the Quran about that, so to have that discussion, there is no need much, because really, I don't think there is any educated Sunni that denies that. Besides, there are so many Sunni narrations that they say, confirming that famous hadith that, again, we have it as well, that لا تقوم الساعة حتى تملأ الأرض ظلما وجورا وعدوانا, that the Prophet says that the Day of Judgment will not come until injustice and corruption is spread on earth. ثم يخرج من أهل بيتي من يملأها قسطاً وعدلاً. Then a person from my progeny, says the Prophet, will come to spread peace and justice on earth. Now, this hadith, Musnad, for example, has narrated many of the Sunnis that have narrated. That's what I told you, that about the concept, there is no dispute. Even Ibn Taymiyyah does not deny the concept of al-Mahdi. The dispute, as I told you, is about whether he is born or he is to be born. And that's what we want to prove based on some of the agreed narrations that we have from both sides. One of the narrations that is mentioned by both Shia and Sunni without doubt and is mutawatir, meaning that so many narrators have narrated it, is the famous Hadith Thaqalain. Muslim, the second most authentic book of Ahlul Sunnah, has narrated that in the book of Virtues of Imam Ali alayhi salam. And the Hadith in short is that the Prophet says that I have left two precious things with you, Kitab Allah wa Itrati Ahl Bayti. So how can we from that prove that the existence of Imam Mahdi? Because the end of the Hadith, in continuation of the Hadith, the Prophet says that وَإِنَّهُمَا لَنْ يَفْتَرِقَا حَتَّى يَرِدَا عَلَيَّ الْحَوْضِ. Please pay attention of the understanding of the Hadith. That the Prophet says that these two, Quran and Ahlul Bayt, will never be, لَنْ يَفْتَرِقَا, will never be separated from one another until together they come to me at the pool of Kothar on the Day of Judgment. That means, so far as we have the original Quran, as we do, we are going to have one of the Ahlul Bayt of the Prophet living as well. So far as we have a living Quran as the living miracle of the Prophet of Islam, we must have a living Imam as the Khalifa and the successor of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is one dalil, one evidence, based on the well-known and accepted Hadith of Thaqalain. The second dalil, it goes back to numbers of riwayat that we have, that khulafa after the Prophet are 12. Bukhari in his Sahih, Muslim in his Sahih, and others, they have narrated this hadith from Jabir ibn Samurah, that he says, with my dad, we went to see the Prophet while he was giving a lecture. In his talk, I heard the Prophet saying that Al-Khulafa'u ba'di isna ashara khalifa. Successors after me are 12. This hadith, some 20 years ago, I presented it to one of the eminent Sunni scholars in Nigeria when I was there. He asked me, and I said to him that, who are those 12? You have it in your books. Count. Let's start counting. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Amirul Mumineen Ali, Muawiyah, Yazid. Can you say that? And even if you can't like that, then how can you come to 12? Believe me, this hadith has puzzled the Sunni narrators and those who are experts in narratology. Has puzzled them. That scholar, he told me that, give me some time to make some investigations. A month later, I went to his town again and we had a discussion. And I said to him that, Sheikh, did you find any meaning for that hadith? He said, still I have not. I have checked all the Shuruh Bukhari and I have not come across any satisfactory explanation. I said, the explanation is so obvious. And see if it's satisfactory on account of the 12 Imams. When I was in Australia the very first few years, I heard that already he had declared himself as a Shia and he's one of the leaders of very famous movement in Nigeria, by the way. Perhaps some brothers, sisters, they know who I'm talking about. Anyway, this hadith again is a hadith that proves the existence of Imam Mahdi, Ajallah Farajah Sharif. How? Let's have a second look. Because the Prophet says that Khulafa after me are 12, and we know about the 11 of them, that Sunnis also have no dispute about their existence. And that's why when you go to Hajj in Medina, in Masjid al-Nabi, you see that the holy names of these 12 Imams are engraved beneath the ceiling of Masjid al-Haram, because they know them and they respect them. So up to Imam Hassan Askari, there is no question about their existence. What about Imam Mahdi? Well, the Prophet didn't say 11, he said 12. Now, if the 12th one is a son of the 11th one, and is not yet born, come on, what are you talking about? Imam Hassan al-Askari has already passed away, and years to come, millenniums to come, God knows when, Imam Mahdi will be born. So there has to be that Mahdi as the 12th Imam, also the son of Imam Askari, is born, but he is in occultation. This is the second proof for the, the living of Imam Mahdi Ajallah Faraj Sharif. Plus, the third one, we have more than 1,000 hadiths, over 1,000 hadiths that our narrators have narrated through authentic chains of narrators, even if not all of them are authentic, collectively they leave us with no doubt that there are so many narrators from the Prophet that the Prophet has named his successors, even from Imam Ali, who has named his successors, from Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein, so until Imam Hassan al-Askari, who has named and clearly mentioned that his son will be the awaited Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. The fourth is the testimony of the pious people, that we have no doubt about their piety, and they are honest and truthful people, tasharrufat, brothers and sisters. Publicly, due to Allah's wisdom, it is not possible to see Imam Mahdi at the moment. But private, to have the honor of private visit, it is not closed and it's not denied. Certain people throughout the time of occultation up until now, they have had the honor of visiting and knowing and recognizing the Imam, either at the time of the visit or after that. The story of Ali ibn Mahziyar al-Ahwazi that we just saw, boys, they narrated it, is one of the so many. Our scholars, they have compiled books. There is one hadith that our fuqaha, they refer to it to prove that the khabar wahid is authentic, and we can rely on one hadith that the narrators are authentic. Part of that hadith has the story of one of the tasharrufat, one of the visits of people to Imam Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Apart from that, see, unless we have a real dollar, there won't be any fake dollar, huh? No one would fake Australian notes unless there is a real notes. The fact that there have been fake sects even within the Shia, as they claim that their leader was al-Mahdi, awaited Mahdi, proves that there is a real Mahdi. Nawusiyyah were one of them, Waqifiyyah were one of them, and so many others to name. Some of the Khulafa ibn al-Abbas, even they named themselves al-Mahdi, such as Khalifa al-Mahdi, one of the Khulafa ibn al-Abbas, because they knew that at that time, close to that time, they were expecting al-Mahdi to be born based on the narrations that they had it as well. Remember, I mentioned to you that Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says that the reason that at our time, the time of occultation, al-Mahdi is in occultation, our present Imam, we don't have the honor and the blessing of seeing him in a normal way, is because it's a test for us, the test of faith. Zurare is the narrator. He says that, I said, Ya Ibn Rasulallah, if I happen to be alive at that time, what am I supposed to do? Is there any particular prayer that you suggest? Imam Sadiq alayhi salam mentions that dua that I want to conclude with, and I urge you and myself to let us remember, memorize, very short dua, and say it all the time. The meaning of it, before I say it, for those who may not be familiar with Arabic language, is that every day pray this dua as the recommendation of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, and ask Allah to introduce, to make himself known to you, so that because of that you get to know his messenger, the Holy Prophet, and make his messenger known to you, so that you get to know the successor of the Prophet, and then he makes your Imam known to you, otherwise we will be lost, as already the Prophet had told it. I hope that we will not be among those. Please join me in this short dua together, and we will conclude with that, and thank you very much for your patience. Wa jazakumullah khair al jaza. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم عرفني نفسك فإن لم تعرفني نفسك لم أعرف نبيك اللهم عرفني رسولك فإنك إن لم تعرفني رسولك لم أعرف حجتك اللهم عرفني حجتك فَإِنَّكَ إِنْ لَمْ تُعَرِّفْنِي حُجَّتَكَ ضَلَلْتُ عَنْ دِينِي وَكُلُّ عَامٍ وَأَنْتُمْ بِأَلْفِ خَيْرٍ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا وَرَحْمَتُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ. For the quick reappearance of Imam al-Hujjah Jalallah Ta'ala Farajahu Sharif, صَلُّوا عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَآلِ مُحَمَّدٍ بِأَعْلَى أَصْوَاتِكُمْ.